we got?
Next week on Behind the Music. You probably don't know that one of the greatest songwriters and producers of our time is virtually unheard of. However, you and your kids know him very well. You just don't know it. Regan Palmzer is responsible for the songs you hear in popular child's toys. He's rolled out hit after hit after hit over his career. But at what price? From humble beginnings, he began his beginnings at the start.
Regan? Man, it was the craziest thing. Any instrument that he picked up, the music just like flowed through him. It was unbelievable. It was so natural. It was like nothing I've seen before. It was unbelievable.
On his rise to the top, he met Murray Rodriguez, a talented musician. Together, they were able to climb the ranks of the musical toy industry to heights they could only dream of, and they did it together.
That's it. All right. Like, I think we got it. Yeah.
Seemingly on top of the world, they had it all: the money, fame, and fortune. Each year, their toys flew off the shelf. Just entering the peak of their career, they signed a lucrative deal with Fisher-Price, one of the giants in the child's toy industry. Together, Palmzer and Rodriguez and Fisher-Price released some of the most popular toys in childhood history. Among them was the Standing House, the Gumball Galore Machine, the Shape Cube.
The use of the slide whistle was executed to perfection. It really took this piece over the top.
There was also the Discover Walker and the Learning Kitchen.
There were some creative differences over what we wanted to do with the kitchen. I wanted to go a more whimsical route, but Regan wanted to stay true to the essence of what it would be like to learn in the kitchen.
The pressure to perform was at an all-time high, with another hit expected for the holiday season. This is when the cracks started to show, and when the strain between Palmzer and Rodriguez was too big to ignore. Midway through their biggest project to date, Rodriguez left the team.
Yeah, in this footage you can see how bad it was getting. It was getting really abusive. He was drunk all the time. It was just bad. I couldn't work under those conditions. I just couldn't do it.
No!
What?
Next!
This is perfectly fine! Everything you
try something else! Try something else!
I have been working on this for years!
Oh. Years! I can do it in 2 minutes!
Stop. Hey. Piano's not your thing, alright? Hey! That's it. I'm gone.
I don't need you anyway. Watch this. I'm Murray Rodriguez. Joke.
With Murray out of the picture, Palmzer was left to deliver the project solo.
Hello, I'm Wallace Carter, CEO of Fisher-Price. Regan Palmzer turned in what he had for the sing-along easel that was set for release during the holiday season. Unfortunately, this is what he presented to us.
What do you see when you look in the mirror? Are you happy now? Happy's when your mouth is smiling. Come on, show me how. You like that, wouldn't you? What do you see when you look in the mirror? Could it be a surprise? Open up that mouth real wide. Oh. Ugh, same thing with those eyes, but I can't see anything. I can't see an end.
Fortunately, we were able to polish it up and deliver it on time.
What do you see when you look in the mirror? Are you happy now? Happy is when your mouth is smiling. Come on, show me how. What do you see when you look in the mirror? Could it be surprise? Open up your mouth real wide. Same thing with those eyes. What do you see?
After this project, he disappeared, never to be seen from again.
Oh, the last time I saw Regan... Yeah, I was walking down the street. I can't be sure it was him, but I did recognize the cardboard box full of children's toys and the sound coming from it. You know, it's sad to see someone who was so good at what they did fall so far and do sexual favors for so little.
Oh, like, I'll talk to, like, Josh, and I'll be like, man, have you seen Regan? No, haven't heard it. Nobody, none of, like, Josh, Tyler, Kyle, none of these guys have heard from him. All the, like, childhood friends that we used to hang out with, nothing.
I think the saddest thing was that this was the most successful child star we've ever released, and it's large part due to the efforts of Palmer and Rod Reagans. Unfortunately, they were never able to see the fruits of their labor.
Although this story may have a tragic end, the music will live on in preschools and playrooms for generations to come.
Right now, we're still living off the benefits of what he produced prior. We have no idea how we're going to match this coming up. We're actually quite concerned.
I remember we'd get together and like play, like, you know, we'd all kind of just jam together, but... Yeah, that was actually probably the last time we hung out with Regan. Probably, yeah, we were jamming in my parents' basement, I think.
I never could figure out how to use these things. Just wrote the music for him, really.
Down. On. A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
I remember writing this one. Took us 3 months. Hard work. But it was teamwork at that point. Those were the good times. But there wasn't to be a next time. Ever again.
That's tragic. Really actually feel bad for that guy.
Well, it's part of the human tapestry, right? You don't think of these things, but they're real.
It's broken. That shit's broken. Lie, try to hide. Now you know it. That I'm at an all time low, 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 low.
for a while. She's probably coming back with so much garlic butter.
Hi, I'm Mike Dwellings. On this episode, we're in beautiful Invermere. See if there's any projects that we can use our expertise on. Roof seems to be in decent condition. But you know, with these places, there's always little holes, you know, heat's escaping, things like that. Let's go take a look. Coming over here. We have chicken wire up here. There's obviously no chickens here, so we can get rid of that. Yeah, it doesn't sound like there's much insulation in here, so we'll put some foam here or something like that. This is a tripping hazard for people that are 12 feet tall. Come over here. Let's take a look at this. So you can see here we have a whole bunch of 2x4s stacked on a log here, a tree. Not exactly solid, but you know, we'll address this and see where we can go from here. You can see up there we have the solar panels. Looks like they're rated for 150,000 amperatures, which obviously isn't a code. These are things that we're here to help with. So I'm excited for this project. So the deck is a place of concern, I think. As you can see, the foundation isn't great. Cantilevered over a little bit, and I think that we can really shore this up, make it a deck that we can use for years to come. Family and friends can enjoy this.
Hey!
Oh, hi, hey. Sir, I'm Mike Dwelling.
Hey, here get to... out of here! Hey!
No, I'm here to help you with your...
Yeah! Get out of here! Got that kid!
Okay, well, apparently, we're not welcome here. And next week on Mike Dwellings, I'll show you how to...
Get!
We'll worry about next week later. We'll worry about next week later. Let's go.
That guy's a fraud.
He just uses his expensive buddies to
do
everything.
It's the same shit every single week.
Yeah. No idea what he's doing. No idea.
I can't believe they even let him. Is he even a contractor?
He doesn't do any work. He just hires his friends and give him a kickback.
I can't watch this.
No.
Say about that.
Next.
Well, that's the end of cable.